हेलो दोस्तों, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट डिफरेंशियल फेज शिफ्ट कीइंग। सो व्हाट इज द बेसिक प्रिंसिपल बिहाइंड डिफरेंशियल फेज शिफ्ट कीइंग, डिफरेंस बिटवीन फेज शिफ्ट कीइंग एंड डिफरेंशियल फेज शिफ्ट कीइंग, एंड आल्सो अबाउट ट्रांसमीटर एंड रिसीवर ब्लॉक डायग्राम ऑफ द डीपीएसके विथ सम एप्लीकेशंस वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल प्रिंसिपल, सो व्हाट इज द मेन प्रिंसिपल बिहाइंड डिफरेंशियल फेज शिफ्ट कीइंग इज डिफरेंशियल फेज शिफ्ट कीइंग डज नॉट नीड अ सिंक्रोनाइजेशन कैरियर एट द डिमोड्यूलेटर। सो इन केस ऑफ फेज शिफ्ट कीइंग वी नो दैट वी नीड अ कैरियर एट बोथ ट्रांसमीटर एंड रिसीवर, बट इन केस ऑफ डिफरेंशियल फेज शिफ्ट कीइंग वी डोंट नीड दिस कैरियर हियर। सो वी विल बी नॉट हैविंग एनी कैरियर एट द आउटपुट साइड और रिसीवर साइड, सो ओनली द कैरियर विल बी एट द ट्रांसमीटर साइड एंड देर इज नो कैरियर एट रिसीवर। सो वील बी यूजिंग फीडबैक फ्रॉम द आउटपुट एंड बाय कंबाइनिंग द इनपुट डाटा एंड फीडबैक वील बी डिटरमाइनिंग द नेक्स्ट डेटा इन केस ऑफ डीपीएसके। सो द इनपुट सिक्वेंस ऑफ बाइनरी बिट्स इज मॉडिफाइड सच दैट द नेक्स्ट बिट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द प्रीवियस बिट। सो नेक्स्ट बिट विल बी डिपेंडिंग, सो सपोज दिस इज द डाटा स्ट्रीम, सो दिस बिट विल बी डिपेंडिंग ऑन द प्रीवियस बिट, this will be depending previous, so this will be depending on this previous bit, so the algorithm is written like this. And so at the receiver the previous bits are used to detect the present bit, as I said previous bits are fed back to detect the present bits. So that's the working of differential phase shift keying. So now we'll see difference between PSK and DPSK. So in PSK we need coherent signal, that is synchronization signal at both ends. As I said, in PSK we require this synchronization signal at both the ends, but in case of DPSK there is no need for coherent signal, so there is no need for coherent signal at the receiver side, so receiver we don't need. So now let us see transmitter block diagram. So transmitter consists of, this is input sequence, that is our data, then it is XOR gate, a sample is taken and delayed by TB bits and it is fed back. So XORing of D of T and B of T minus TB will give B of T, so balanced modulator, that is the carrier is added here and we will be getting a signal, that is DPSK signal, square root of 2P cos 2 pi F naught T. So this is square root of 2p is nothing but the DC offset, that is DC level of the signal. Okay, so B of T is detected by XORing of D of T and B of T minus TB. So how XOR function works, D of T, B of T minus TB. 0 in polar form I can write minus 1 and 1 I will be writing 1 1. So when they both are low, the output will be low. When both are high, the output will be low. Otherwise it will be high. So 0 0, output will be 0. 1 1, output will be 0. If 0 and 1, if one of the bit is high, then the output will be high. So for similar bits we will be getting 0, and if the bits are different we will be getting 1. That's the function of XOR. So the transmitter is like this. Now how we can draw the waveform for the transmitter of a DPSK? Okay, so there are two conditions, upcoming data is 1, the change, then change polarity of output. So if the upcoming data is 1, change the polarity of output. If upcoming data is 0, then don't change polarity. So suppose this is our data stream, I have assumed this one. So if let us con the okay, we have drawn the our input as it is. So how DPSK we can draw? So one, as draw as it is, upcoming data is 0, so upcoming data is 0, then don't change the polarity. So I don't change polarity, I will come up to this. Now data is 1, change the polarity up to this. Now data is again 1, change the polarity to positive. Data is 1, change the polarity to negative. Data is 0, don't change polarity. Data is 1, change polarity. Data is 1, change polarity. Data is 0, don't change polarity. Data is 1, now again I will change the polarity and this will come like this. Okay, this will continue like this. So how, this is how we can draw a waveform of DPSK depending on these two conditions. Now coming to receiver. So what is receiver? This is basically correlator low pass filter. Okay, so integrating 0 to TB, D of T means a low pass filter is there. So B of T square root of 2P cos omega 2, we have received this signal which we have previously transmitted, then a delayed version of which is taken and given to this multiplier, then we will be getting output signal y of t. So then it is passed to low pass filter and sampled, given to decision device to get the binary sequence, that is 0 or 1 we will be getting at this point. So if input and delayed versions are in same polarity, there are also two conditions. So this is first one and this is second one. If input and delayed versions are in the same polarity, so these two are having, so this one and this one, same polarity means they are having same sign. Y of t equal to, I have neglected this DC offset, that can be removed by filtering. So we will be having B of t cos omega t into the delayed version is also same polarity, B of t cos omega t. So B square of t cos square omega t, we know that cos square omega t equal, I can write it as 1 by 2 1 plus cos 2 omega. So that is cos square theta equal to 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2, that is 1 by 2 1 plus cos 2 theta. By using this formula I can write like this, B square by 2 1 plus cos 2 of omega t. So when I pass through low pass filter, this component will be filtered out, and then I will be left with B square of t by 2. So this is positive, and I will be in algorithm I will be indicating this as 1. So I will be getting binary 1. So if input and delayed versions are opposite polarity, then we will be having different sign. At that time we will be doing same steps and we will be getting minus B square by 2. So negative means 0. So binary 0 and 1 will be getting out of this. So like this we can estimate the data at the output. So some of the advantages are, circuit is less complex due to non-coherent detection and cost is less. Okay, so we will be requiring only one carrier at the transmitter, so the circuit will be less complex and cost will be reduced. And disadvantage, noise is more as compared to the PSK, so noise will be more in this case. So that's all about QPSK. So in my next video I'll be explaining about offset QPSK. And thank you guys, thanks for your support. If you have not subscribed to the channel, please guys do subscribe, because I will be posting this type of videos recently. So thank you, thanks for watching.